Hello, I'm Ms. Schaefer. Welcome to our spring musical review. Thanks for viewing as our students share in singing, handbells, and acting. This whole experience has, and I hope will continue, to open the curiosity of our students to explore more musical literature and to spark singing. Enjoy!
Thank you. A drip of German bread. upon a time in a far-off kingdom. Cinderella's mother had died and father had taken a new wife, a woman with two daughters of her own. All three were beautiful of face but vile and black of heart.
You want to go to the festival?
The festival?
The king's festival?
Jack, on the other hand, had no father, and his mother...
I wish.
Well, she wasn't quite as fancy as the others.
Welcome in, little girl. I wish a loaf of bread for my granny who lives in the wood, please.
What a beautiful red paper one.
I've emptied a pot of lentils into ashes for you. If you pick them out again in tomorrow's time, you should go to the ball with us.
Cinderella called to the birds so that they might pluck the lentils from the fireplace and put them in the pot. As for the baker, he had lost his family in a baking accident, or so that he was told, and he was eager to make a family of his own.
Who's that?
It's the witch from next door!
The old witch explained that she had a spell on their house because the baker's father had stolen beans from her garden.
Beans?
Special magical beans.
The witch punished the baker's parents by taking their baby girl from them and locking her away in a far high tower.
Lead Milky Way to the market, fetch the best price you can. Take no less than 5 pounds. Are you listening to me?
Yes, Mother.
Know how much you'd ask?
No more than five.
Less than five.
You look beautiful.
I know.
She means me.
Put it in a twist.
We'll be at the festival.
Although Cinderella fulfilled the task her stepmother had set, still would not allow her to attend the king's festival.
You make us the fools of the festival and mortify the prince.
The carriage is waiting.
You must be gone.
You wish to have the curse of hers? You'll need a certain potion first. Go to the woods and bring it back. 1. The cow is white as milk. 2. The cape is red as blood. 3. The hair is yellow as corn. And 4. The slipper is pure as gold. Bring me these before the chime of midnight in 3 days' time, and you will have, I guarantee, a child as perfect as child can be. Go to the woods!
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slip is pure as gold.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slip is pure as gold.
So the baker, with newfound determination, went after the red cape. And as for the little girl, she was surprised to find her grandmother's cottage door standing wide open.
Good day, grandmother.
My grandmother, you're looking very strange. What big ears you have.
The better to hear you with, my dear.
But grandmother, what big eyes you have.
The better to see you with, my dear.
Oh, grandmother, what a terrible, big, wet mouth you have.
The better to eat you with.
With his appetite appeased, the wolf took a long nap.
That grandmother has a mighty snore. What is that red cloth in the corner of your mouth?
What a fright! How dark and dank it was inside that wolf.
Kill the devil!
Granny!
Cry, child, this evil must be destroyed.
Well, I'll leave you to your task.
Don't you want the skins?
No, you keep them.
What kind of hunter are you?
I'm a baker.
Have you seen a beautiful young woman in a ball gown pass through?
I don't think so, sir.
I think I see her over there. I've never lied to royalty before. I've never anything to royalty before.
Thank you.
What a beautiful ball gown you're wearing.
Were you at the King's Festival?
Yes.
Are you the lucky one? If a prince were pursuing me, I certainly would hide. Tell me about the ball.
It's a very nice ball.
Yes. And?
They have far too much food.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
If he knew who I really was.
Oh.
Who? I'm afraid I was rude.
Yes, and?
Now I'm being pursued.
Yes, and?
And I'm not in the mood.
Are you to return to the festival tomorrow, E?
Perhaps.
Perhaps? All to be pursued by a prince. All that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. My one gift to being your shoe.
Would you look over there? An enormous vine growing next to that little cottage.
I mean slippers.
It looks like a giant beanstalk rising into the sky.
As pure as gold.
I must get home.
Wait! I need your shoe! Hey, come back here!
As for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose this beauty to the outside world, and so shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep within the forest.
Ah, there you are, dear brother. Father and I have wondered where you have been.
I have been looking all night. For her.
Her?
The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where'd she go?
Disappeared like a fine morning mist.
She was lovely.
The loveliest.
I must confess, I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, on the top of a tall tower that has no door or stairs.
How do you manage your visit?
I stand beneath the tower and say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And she lowers the longest one, beautiful head of hair, yellow's corn, which I climbed to.
Ha ha ha! Rapunzel, Rapunzel, what kind of name is that, you jest? I've never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth. She is as true as your maiden, a maiden running from a prince. Now you can run from us.
Yet one has.
Where did she go?
Who?
Don't play the fool, woman!
Oh, you mean the beautiful young maiden in the ball gown? She went in that direction. I was trying to hold her here for you.
I can capture my own damsel, thank you.
You have the cow.
Yes, I have the cow. We have two of the four.
Three.
Two.
Three. Compare this to your corn.
Where did you find it?
I pulled it for a minute in a tower.
Three.
And I almost had the four, but she got away.
We have one entire day left. Surely we can locate the slipper by then.
We? You mean you'll allow me to stay?
Well, maybe it will take the two of us to break the spell.
What a beautiful cape!
Stay away from my cape, or I'll slice you into a thousand bits!
I don't want it! I was just admiring it!
My granny made it for me, from a wolf that attacked us, and I got to skin the animal. And best of all, she gave me this beautiful knife for protection.
Well, look what I have! A hen that lays golden eggs!
I don't believe that egg came from that goose. Where did you get that egg?
I stole this from the kingdom of the giant. Up there! And if you think this is something, you should see the golden heart the giant has. It has the most beautiful tunes without your even having to touch it.
Of course it does. Why don't you go up to the kingdom right now and bring it back and show me?
I could.
You could not.
I could.
You could not, Mr. Liar.
I am not a liar. I'll get that heart. You'll see.
Together, 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 all of us have to
my swamp.
Well, gosh, we were forced to come here.
Forced by who?
Lord Farquaad. He moved and he moved and he signed the deviation notice.
Huh? Well, not my problem. Now, you all need to turn around and go back from where you came from.
Go back? We can't go back.
Farquaad will learn us at the Brock first.
The guy's bad news.
Hey, maybe you could talk to him.
Yeah, he'll listen to you. You're big and scary.
I'm also an ogre, which means I stay on my swamp and avoid large crowds. Or haven't you read the stories?
You mean those stories that say I'm a big, bad wolf?
And the ones that say I'm a wicked witch?
And the ones that say I'm a wooden boy? What? I'm not a wooden boy! I have a great inner condition!
Look here, ogre, I'm gonna spell that for you. You're the only one tough enough to stand that no good film farmer Farquaad.
Okay, fine. I get it. Attention all fairy tale things. I'm gonna go see this Farquaad guy right now and get you all off my land and back from where you came from. Well, this can't be right. I'm all turned around. I took a right at the candy house, passed that weird old woman in the shoe, and then took a left at Bella's in the house of lamb chops.
Ah! Let me get out, would you? I'm being chased by a goo!
Ah! Oh, it's hideous! That's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Step aside, Shrek, and let us at him.
Why? What did he do?
I don't want to die! I don't want to die! I don't want to die!
He's a talking donkey! A freak of nature! As are you, you unsavory beast!
Hey, now. You're going the right way for a smackdown.
By the order of Lord Farquaad, I authorize to place both of you under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? Boom! This is the part where you run away. And don't come back. Now, which way to Duloc?
Can I just say, that was incredible! Man, they were tripping over themselves to get away from you. I like that.
Oh, good. I'm glad. Now why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
Well, I don't have any friends.
Oh, now there's a shocker.
That's Luke. Say, you lost or something?
No, I'm just trying to figure out the best route to Duloc.
Oh, Duloc! I know Duloc! You gotta let me show you the way, because I'm like a GPS, but with fur.
I'll be fine on my own, thanks.
Well, nobody's fine on their own. Not when you look like we do. Hey! Did you hear what they said? Man, this place is going stepford. We gotta join forces. Otherwise, they're gonna lock me up and I cannot go back in the cage. I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata.
All right, look, only because I'm lost. You can come.
Yeah, woohoo, all right.
One condition, you keep the jabbering to a minimum.
You got it, no jabbering. Man, you will not regret this.
Too late.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Shrek and Donkey, two Star Wars fans off on a whirlwind big city adventure.
Oh, it's you. What a terrific surprise. And lucky you, you're here at torture time. Bring in the cookie.
No, I won't, Speaker, I won't.
Run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man.
You're a monster!
I'm not the monster here. You are. You and the rest of that fairy tale trash poisoning my perfect kingdom.
It's not a kingdom because you're not a king.
Oh, but I will be just as soon as I find a princess to marry. And I hear you know one. Tell me where she is.
Wait, me!
That's it. My patience has reached its end. Present the devices of torture.
Now wait a minute. Let's not get crazy. Maybe I have heard tell of a princess.
From who?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man.
Yes, I know the Muffin Man. He lives on Drury Lane.
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
He heard it from the Muffin Man.
My God.
You haven't told me where she is.
I can't!
You must.
I won't!
Tell me you're out.
No! Not the buttons! Not my gumdrop buttons!
Then where is the princess?
Okay, I'll tell you. She just a day's walk from here in a dragon cart and castle surrounded by hot boiling lava.
Well, that sounds dangerous.
You want a princess or not?
Go on.
In the highest room in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery redhead named Princess Fiona.
Oh, Princess Fiona. She sounds perfect. Except for that dragon and lava thing. I'll have to find someone else to go.
Big surprise.
I shall make Fiona my queen, and Duloc will finally have the perfect kid. Captain, take the cookie to the swamp with the rest of those fairy tale freaks.
Swamp? That's the things I get!
My loyal subjects, we're going to get a queen.
Ugh, like I never heard that reaction before. Hey, are you Lord Farquaad?
Maybe. Does the name strike fear in your heart?
No, but that little hat does.
Who let this thing in here?
Look, I'll be out of your silky little hair just as soon as you give me my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Yes, where you dumped all those fairy-tale creatures.
Newsflash, Ogre. That oozing mud pit is actually within the province of Duloc, and therefore, my swamp.
Now look here, half-pint.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oh, this is too perfect.
What is?
You! You're big and hulking and wonderfully expendable. People of Duloc, we have a winner!
Hooray!
Congratulations, Ogre. You've won the honor of embarking a great and noble quest.
But we're already on a quest.
To get my swamp back.
Yes, and you've nearly accomplished it. All you need to do is rescue Princess Fiona from the dragon, bring her to me, to Mary, and I'll hand over the deed to your swamp.
You know, I don't get it, Trent. Why don't you just make Farquaad give you the swamp back? You know, pull some of that ogre stuff on me.
For your information, there's a lot more to ogres than you think.
Example.
Okay, ogres are like onions.
They stink?
Yes. No!
They make you cry!
No!
Oh, you leave them out in the sun, they get all brown and start sprouting those little white hairs?
No! Layers! Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. Onions have layers. You get it? We both have layers.
Oh, you both have layers. You know, not everybody likes onions. Parfaits! Everyone likes parfait, and they have layers. Have you ever met a person and you say, hey, let's get some parfaits? And they say, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Ogres are not like parfaits.
Parfaits may be the most delicious thing on this whole planet.
You know, this may turn into the longest day of my entire life.
Did you see that? Did you see that? Check here, found an axe laying right there in the tired old castle, and then bam! He cut the rope, and the rope held this old gothic-looking chandelier, and the chandelier fell right on the dragon, and that's how he escaped. Who the man? Who the man? Shrek the man.
You did it. You did it. You did it. You did it. You're amazing. You're wonderful. You're a little unorthodox, I'll admit, but thy deed is great, and thine heart is pure. I'm eternally in your debt.
Ahem.
And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
All right, I hope you heard that. She called me a noble steed. She thinks I'm a steed.
Well, Sir Shrek, the battle is won. You may remove your helmet.
No.
Why not?
I have helmet hair.
Please, I wouldn't look upon the face of my rescuer.
No, you wouldn't.
But how will you kiss me?
What? That wasn't in the job description.
Maybe it's a perk.
No, it's destiny. A princess is rescued by a brave knight. And then they share true love's first kiss.
With Shrek? You think that Shrek is your true love?
What is so funny?
Well, let's just say I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now remove your helmet.
Look, I really don't think that's a good idea.
Just take off the helmet.
I'm not going to.
Take it off.
No.
Now.
Okay. Fine, easy, at your command, Your Highness.
You're an ogre?
What, were you expecting Prince Charming?
Well, yes, actually. Oh no, I'm supposed to be rescued by my true love. not by some ogre and his pet.
Well, so much for noble steed.
You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Princess, I was sent here by Lord Farquaad, all right? He's the one who wants to marry you.
Oh, then why didn't he come rescue me?
Good question. You should ask him when we get there. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset.
So?
I didn't realize it was so late. We need to make a camp.
Camp? But we just escaped.
Yes, and I found that whole ordeal quite exhausting. I need to rest immediately.
That's unfortunate, because we're gonna keep on going.
I need to find somewhere to camp right now!
Very well. There's a cave right over there.
Shrek, that's a place for a princess.
No, it's perfect. Well, gentlemen, I bid thee good night.
Want me to read you a bedtime story? Because I will.
I said good night.
She seems nice. You want me to read you a bedtime story?
Say good night, donkey.
Good night, donkey. Donkey! Oh, sorry. I just got caught up in the magic of the night. The fireflies, the beautiful sunset.
Sunset? Oh my gosh, sunset. Oh no, I mean, it's late. It's very late.
What?
I'm sorry, but I have to go.
Oh, all right.
Good night.
Good night.
No, sir. I'm sorry, but I did not come this whole way putting up with you and your body odor, just so you can let her walk away like that.
What are you talking about?
Hey, I'm an animal, and I got instincts. And you two were obviously digging for each other.
Oh, you're crazy. I'm just bringing her back to Lord to Farquaad.
Uh-huh. So you don't have any feelings for her at all?
Look, even if I did, and I'm not saying I do, because I don't, she's a princess, and I'm...
An ogre?
Yeah, an ogre.
She needs to know what you're feeling.
Where are you going?
To get more firewood before your fire dies. Shrek, did you see the sunset? Man, it's dark out here. Good thing I've got this firewood.
Shrek, ooh, maybe he's talking to the princess. I'll just say if they're in the barn together. Shrek, Princess Fiona. It's very spooky in here. I am playing no games. Ah!
No, it's okay. Donkey, it's okay.
Ah! Oh no! Help! Shrek! Help me, Shrek! Princess, what happened to you?
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm. Until you find true love's kiss, and then take love's true form.
That's beautiful. I didn't know you wrote poetry.
It's a curse. I've had it since I was a girl.
A curse?
A witch cast a spell on me. So now, every night, when the sun goes down, I become this horrible, ugly beast.
Wait a second. This is perfect.
Perfect? Donkey, if Lord Farquaad finds out I look like this, he'll never marry me.
So?
So, I have to kiss my true love. The kiss is the only thing that will break the spell and make me beautiful.
But you know, you're kind of an ogre, and Shrek, well, you've got a lot in common.
Shrek?
Yeah, if he knew all this, I think maybe...
No, he can't know, and you can't tell him. Not a word, not one must ever know. Promise you won't tell? Promise?
All right. I won't tell him, but you should. Man, I know when this is all over, I'm gonna need a whole lot of serious therapy.
I can't think about Shrek, not now. I'm a princess after all. And look at me, I mean, really, who could ever love a beast so hideous and ugly? Princess and ugly don't go together. That's why I can't stay here with Shrek. My only chance to live happily ever after is to marry my one true love. Shrek, thank goodness. There's something I have to tell you.
You don't have to tell me anything. I've heard everything last night.
Oh, you heard what I said?
Every word, especially, who could love such a hideous, ugly monster?
But I thought that wouldn't matter to you.
Yeah, well it does. All right on time, princess! I brought you a little something.
Whoa, broomstick horse, Princess Fiona.
As promised, now about my swamp.
Cleared off, as agreed, and the deed has been put in your name. Now step away before I change my mind. Forgive me, Princess, for startling you. I am Lord Farquaad.
Lord Farquaad, forgive me, for I was just saying a short farewell.
Oh, that is so sweet, but you don't have to waste good manners on the ogre. It's not like it has feelings.
No, you're right. It doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, fair, flawless Fiona, I ask your hand in marriage. Will you be the perfect bride for the perfect groom?
Lord Farquaad, I accept. Nothing would make me...
Excellent! I'll start the plans for tomorrow. We wed.
No! I mean, why wait? Let's get married today, before sunset.
Oh, anxious, are we? You're right. The sooner the better. There's so much to do. Captain, ride ahead and tell them it's a code red. We'll be married by sunset.
Oh man, there's nothing like a good night's sleep. What'd I miss?
Fare thee well, Ogre.
Shrek!
Shrek, what are you doing? You let her get away! There's something you don't know! I talked to her last night, and...
Yeah, I know you talked to her last night. You two are great pals, aren't you? So why don't you follow her home?
But Shrek, I want to go home with you.
Me? No. I live alone. My swamp, me. Nobody else. Understand? Nobody. Especially useless, pathetic, annoying, talking donkeys.
Well, I thought...
Yeah, well, you know, you thought wrong.
Just when you think life can't get any worse, you get evicted from a swamp.
Well, look who it is.
I thought you were going to help us. Instead, you had us kicked out.
Well, what did you expect from an ogre?
We believed in you.
Aw, grow up.
I won't grow up.
Then get out of my way.
Well, there he goes again, pushing everyone away. Just like he did to me, and just like he did to Fiona. You're so wrapped up in layers, onion ball, you're afraid of your own feelings.
Who's Fiona?
Mind your business, pork chop.
She's the princess who loves him.
Oh, there's a girl.
Now it's getting interesting.
The princess loves him.
Loves me? She said I was ugly, a hideous creature. I heard you two talking.
She wasn't talking about you! She was talking about, somebody else!
She wasn't talking about me? Well then, who was she talking about?
Oh, now he's interested! 2 minutes ago, he was all like, come back to me, go away! I don't need nobody!
Look, I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry. I guess I'm just a big, stupid ogre. Which is why the princess and I can never be together.
Listen up, ogre.
He liked me hand so much that he has followed me ever since. from land to land, from sea to sea. He's followed the ship, licking his lips for the rest of it.
In a way, it is sort of a compliment.
Well, I want no such compliments. Smee, that crocodile would have crept upon me longer if he had caught me up unaware. By some lucky chance, he swallowed. And it goes on, tick, tock, tick, within him. And so, before he can reach me, I hear the tick.
One day, the clock will run down, and then he'll get you.
Aye, that is the fear that hunts.
Ooh! What's the matter, Captain?
Smee, the sea's hot. Oh, it's very hot. Odds, bobs, hammers, and tongs. Smee, help me! A chimney. Peter and the boys must be living underground.
Listen!
Call back the band! So they say Peter Pan's away from home. I must think. Inspire me!
What tempo, Captain?
Tempo, tempo, tempo. A tango! Then hoist them up!
think my mother would like me to be a pirate. Would your mother like you to be a pirate slightly?
I don't think so. Would your mother like you to be a pirate twin?
I don't think so. Curly, would your mother-
Stow that gas! You, boy, you look as though you had a little pluck in you. Would you dream of becoming a pirate, sweetheartie?
What would you call me if I joined?
Blackbeard Joe.
Can I still be faithful to the flag?
You would have to swear down with the flag.
Aye! Then I refuse.
I refuse.
That seals your doom.
Peter!
No words of mine.